typewriter, recorded sound, speech recognition, all of these technologies were originally designed or greatly improved on by pioneers in accessibility. By finding solutions for people with unique abilities, accessibility researchers often end up making technology work better for everyone. I'm Claire, and I'm a designer from the NYU Ability Project. We've been collaborating with Google and innovators from the disability community on a project called Creatability. It's a series of starter experiments that explore ways we can make creative tools more accessible using AI on the web. Each experiment expands creative possibilities by designing for all kinds of inputs, whatever works best for someone.
My name is Chansey Fleet. I am a technology educator and accessibility advocate. Sound Canvas enables a non-visual user to draw on the screen in a variety of ways, including using a mouse, using stylus, using arrow keys, or even using body tracking technology, and receive immediate real-time feedback about the drawing that they're doing, in the form of sound that is pitched higher on the vertical plane or lower and panned in stereo from left to right so that the individual can develop a real sense of where they are with their drawing in space.
My name is Jay Allen Zimmerman and I'm a composer who became deaf. Seeing music is a way to experience music through your eyes instead of your ears. There's a series of tools that will help you to understand music and musical sounds. So you're going to get a sense of volume, emotion, intensity. I feel it's really important that people have access to these tools so you can start experimenting.
Half to six.
Okay.
No, you just did it right now. You
can't hear it, but I can feel it.
We've also been exploring new ways for people to create music using their head or body.
My name is Barry Faramond. I'm a co-founder of Open Up Music, an organization that empowers young disabled people to create inclusive youth orchestras. So Clarion Light is an introductory musical instrument to get people started on their musical journey. It opens up the opportunities to interact with a musical instrument. It broadens it out from just 10 fingers to any part of your body. By putting that musical instrument online, we're opening up access to people around the world. It's an amazing thing.
One of the key things that makes all of this possible is Tensorflow JS, making machine learning algorithms more accessible to anyone right in the web browser. It's all happening on your computer. So this allows us to not only give you a faster frame rate to make this an enjoyable experience, a fluid experience, but it also makes it so that your data is completely private to you.
Anyone with access to the internet, a browser, and a webcam can just click and instantly try these experiments. These collaborations are really just the beginning. We're excited to see how other developers will build on what we've started here.
I think it's an open invitation to the community of developers to engage with what's already available and iterate and really move forward the state of the art. This is a great beginning.